A veteran racer from Liechtenstein, he took the bronze in the giant slalom. He skis equally as well in both. Has three top 10 finishes in the slalom. Won the first one at Kranz Kogora December the 2nd. The only other winner on the slalom World Cup circuit this year other than Stenmark and Girardelli of Luxembourg.
Okay, Frank, five out of the first seven races have already fallen on the bottom part of this course because it is so steep and icy.
We've only got two down, Steve Mayer and Nelson of Sweden. It's really something. We could have a short field in the second run, about 3 minutes of it.
One thing we might remember, first of all, Wenzel had trouble right out of the starting gate.
You believe this happening?
Three gates. He was all tied up in knots. I'm sure he was thinking about the others who had fallen. I can't believe it, because he's a good competitor. Usually a racer coming out of the starting blocks gets a few gates to get warmed up, but he just kind of never got on his skis at all. Right behind, right off the bat, sat back on his skis, coming down through here, missed the next gate, obviously had nothing to do but to stop in the competition. And Andy Wenzel, who is such a great ski racer, is really a disappointment.
Steve Mayer looking up the hill, and they are wiping out. We've lost six out of eight. Only two have made it down the hill. Steve Mayer and, of course, Nelson of Sweden. And now Paul Fremald, another veteran from Liechtenstein, 26 years old, three top 10 finishes in the slalom. The sixth and the third thus far this year. A good veteran, Bob.
Interestingly enough, Andreas Wenzel's father, who just preceded him, was his first coach. And he is also very good at ice, but he's going to have to stay on his skis because this hill is taking its toll. It's a tough one.
Great racing family from Liechtenstein. His brother was a bronze medalist in 76 in this very event. Yes, Steve Mayer's time of the best. One of two racers that has been able to negotiate this hill. And way back,
he's having a good run, though, Frank. He's only 700 per second.
Right.
Look to me like he's straddled the gate. We're going to have to take a look at that. With those poles that flip over like this and then pop up, it's very difficult to tell sometimes.
It did look like he DQ'd up at the top. The running time continues at the bottom. He was close to Steve up on the top.
But he is skiing a lot more within himself, a little bit more technically sound as he goes through the finish here. Pretty good run. Good run.
Not bad. 15 hundredths of a second behind Steve Mayer, but who knows about that gate up there. We'll be checking it out.
Well, Frank, let's take a look at that right now, see what we can see. Coming down here, he looked in very good shape. Got around this pole all set. Coming in here now, this is the one that could be in question. Oh, and it looks to me like he definitely stepped right on the pole, straddled it. We'll have to wait, though, of course, until the entire run is completed before the officials give us the disqualifications, but I'm sure he's out.
And coming up shortly, the run of Phil Mayer, the leader, Steve Mayer's twin brother. Jim McKay profiles the best the United States has ever produced in alpine ski racing.
In the Mayer family of White Pass, Washington, it's always been a case of compete or perish. Mary and Dave Mayer raised their brood at the foot of White Pass Mountain, where the father still is mountain manager. The count is nine children, five spouses, nine grandchildren, and two more on the way. Phil Mayer's sense of family is as strong as his passion for competition. Both loves are enhanced by his relationship with twin brother Steve.
I think that having a twin brother, I was very fortunate in the sense that you never really competed against him, but you always wanted to be as good at something as he was. But I think I'm more competitive with myself than I am with anybody else. You have to want it more than the next person.
To find the key to Phil Mayer, consider his father Dave, an intense man who recently tried to climb Mount Everest at age 54. He thinks nothing's impossible.
You've got to have some ego. That intensity or tenacity or whatever you want to term it is what makes true champions.
That's with Phil and Steve. You break a leg in skiing, you better get back on the boards the first day that you can stand the pain and ski again.
You don't do it for a coach. You don't do it for your family. You don't do it for your country. You do it for yourself. And that's very selfish, but that's sports.
So Dave Mayer calls it tenacity, and Phil calls it selfish. Whatever that something is, it extends to all areas of Phil's life, flat out, all the way. He spent almost every free moment of the last three summers building a house for himself with help from Steve. Everything had to be perfect. But that absolute dedication to perfection can exact a heavy toll. The way Phil lives, there's not much left to give to anybody else. a man caught in a struggle between personal success and domestic responsibility. His first marriage failed. He started over with 22-year-old Holly, a twin herself, and their 1.5-year-old daughter, Lindsay. He seems to be thinking differently now.
It's definitely a big change because you think you run the show and you don't. Well, the biggest thing is it's changed my priorities a lot. I realized that the World Cup circuit is no place to raise a family, and it's no longer just you. And once again, the sport is selfish, and when there's a family, you can't afford to be selfish.
Phil took Holly and Lindsay with him during last year's World Cup tour, but every off-season moment he spent building the house. Now she's pregnant again. It wasn't until they moved in that he realized how much it hurt to not spend enough time with his family.
I don't get enough the way it is. I don't know. In the morning and at night, during the day, the whole time, I get to see my family. It's important.
Well, since we moved in, it's been a lot better, but during the, building process, he was gone at 6 or 7 in the morning, and he'd work all day until it gets dark, and then he'd come home and Lindsay'd be in bed already. So it's, he didn't really get to share a lot of that younger time except on the World Cup. But now that we've moved in, he's gonna be in. And then not on to the circuit again.
Yeah.
A look at Phil Mayer, who's ready for the first run of his final Olympic competition. Steve Mayer, his brother, is in first place. Paul Vermeld of Liechtenstein is second. We suspect he's been disqualified. Nielsen of Sweden is in third place. We'll be right back. Pressure for this man, silver medalist at the slalom in Lake Placid in 1980. We'll never forget it. Led Stengemark, Ingemar Stenmark, after the first race. He took the silver medal up there. Then he went on to win 3 overall World Cup championships. A great ski racer. It's been a tough year for him, however. His decision, his self-announced decision to give up the World Cup tour after nearly a decade and really leading the U.S. Alpine ski team out of the doldrums to the very top of the heap, if you will. Here's his brother with the best time at the bottom. They have talked back and forth on the walkie-talkie. A lot of pressure on Phil. His wife Holly in Scottsdale, Arizona, with her parents awaiting the arrival of a child. And the snow was bad around Christmas time. Phil and Steve had to go back to get training runs in their home state of Washington. And here he is, his last Olympics ahead of him. His brother at the bottom of the hill is the leader. His best finish thus far was at Kitzbühel this year, a fourth place in the slalom. He disqualified twice. Here he is.
Okay, Frank, the one thing that Steve has told him at the bottom is plant that pole and make sure you ski well, particularly off the top. That's the key, I think. And he's all over the place at the top. You can see those hands getting back. He's going to have to get on them if he's going to make it down as it gets steeper. Oh, he's skiing a little bit better right now. Pressure's off him just a little bit because Steve's sitting down in first place.
Mayer's time on the right is running. That's his brother Steve. He has the best time up at the top. And Phil, a little slow as the course is starting to get a little chattery up on the top.
Okay, he was a little ragged at the top, but I think he's skiing a lot better right now. You can see him on his skis better down here. He's skiing an awful lot better. He's on his skis better down here.
The rhythm is there now.
The key is to keep planting that pole. Use those knees and ankles.
Running time on the right. His brother Steve Mayer's time will come up on the left. He is the leader.
He's going to have a pretty good time, Frank.
Fourth place. And could be third, depending upon Vermeld of Liechtenstein, who it looked like missed the gate. Phil Mayer successfully down. He finished 8th at the Giant Slalom a few days ago, and I'm sure that he was disappointed with that finish. He'd like to come back here and add another Olympic medal to the silver that he already possesses from Lake Placid in 1980. And again, in his final season of competition, much on this young man's mind, but you can't take away what he has done for skiing in the United States.
Well, he was a little shaky at the top, Frank, but he was certainly on him at the bottom. He's in good position for the second run.